Welcome to The Sacred Circle, a podcast about all things spiritual and mystical. From magic to meditation, from consciousness to ceremony, this podcast is dedicated to all of you seekers after truth out there. This is an invitation to all of you who still believe in magic, to all of you who respect the unseen, to all of you who don't take myths, legends, and ghost stories for granted. I am your host and guide, Dr. Alex. I don't claim to be an expert, a master practitioner, a shaman, or a medicine man. What I am is a seeker after truth. Welcome to the Sacred Circle. Join us every week on Binge On This, where you can find other shows like Happy News with Perry Kurtz, This, That, and the Other, Reading Ronin, What's Hood with Forever Cabron. Looking forward to delving into the unseen with you every week.
Cigarette butts in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I drink.
Please stop drinking it. Now.
I drink the cigarette bottle.
Do you watch Tim and Eric? Yeah, it's like it's a spaghetti cigarette juice. All right, here we go. 3, 2, we're trying one.
Welcome everybody to This, That, and the Other on the Binge On This channel. My name is Zach. We got all kinds of crazy motherfuckers in the room today. We're gonna start going around in a circle, introduce everybody. Right here to my right, we got
Jordan Macias of Jordan More Chairs Comedy. You can find me on Instagram and OnlyFans.
Yo!
Inmate number 334.
Nice. Hi, I'm Nick, and I'm an alcoholic.
Nice.
You can find me at Wacky Shack 360 on Instagram. That's about it.
That's about it.
What's up? It's Sam. You can find me at Zozo _ Art Studio. Yeah. Oh, wait, we're staying on me? Oh, shit. We don't have another one.
And it's me. My name is Brian. And it's This, That, and the Other. Well, I can't hear it. Can you hear it?
Yeah, I can hear you.
I can hear you.
Hear
we yeah. all hear you.
Yeah, I meant the applause and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
All right, hey.
That bong is simply not big enough.
Hey, ho, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of This, That, and the Other. My name is The Real _ Brian TV, and as always, you guys know that we are brought to you live by Binge On This channel.
Woo!
If you guys want to figure out more about Binge On This channel, simply Google Binge On This or simply search anywhere iTunes related. That's right. Now, if it's your first time, cue me up. Cue me up with some
brought
music
to you by Cambion.
Rest in peace.
Not anymore.
Oh yeah.
Sounds so
ooh,
low.
It's funky.
Why is it so low? I don't like it. I don't like it. Crank it up, man.
All right, Keith Richards.
I'm Keith Richards. If this is your first time listening to us, thank you so much. I don't know who is threatening.
And it's the last time listening to us.
Exactly. And if this is your last time listening to us, good luck. You know, we love you very much. And the world's going to end very, very soon.
Buddy, don't kick the stool out from under you. We love you. We love you. Don't kick the stool out.
But enough of that, because usually we spend about 30 minutes bullshitting. There's too many people in this goddamn room, so let's get this motherfucker started, dog. As you guys know, everybody takes a little bit of time to rant. about things that have happened to him recently. So let's go ahead and start to the left with the main man, Sam. Sam, what do you have on your rant calendar, dog?
Get up.
Good rant.
Yeah. Solid.
Fucking throats.
Very nice.
I could rant out about a lot, I guess, of life stuff, but I don't know. I don't want to just unload my life bullshit on you guys. But
do it. Yeah. Do it.
Unload, baby.
What
unload.
Are we here for?
We got our own problems.
Yeah. We all got problems. But
everyone got problems.
I was driving over here, speaking about problems, and I was listening to a country song. Country came on the radio, which was kind of weird. But I listened to some country song, and I was kind of like, this is pretty cool. And then I started listening to the lyrics, and I'm like, this is pretty interesting. And he was basically, the song was like, you can't buy happiness. You can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt.
Also can't buy decent podcast equipment.
That hurt.
Talking like it is.
That hurt. You're gonna let that plebe come in here and say some shit?
It's cold blooded.
Oh.
So you said you can't buy dirt?
Slow burn.
No, you can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt.
What did it mean by that?
Dirt's tight.
Like, dirt is happiness?
Like, God is, and he goes on to say, God didn't create any more of this. And
didn't create any more dirt?
No, like, this is what we got. And so, you can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt. And then you're gonna find that lady, and you're gonna buy her a diamond ring. You're gonna fall on one knee on that dirt, and then you're gonna build your family, and then add a notch, an extra couple roots in your tree.
No. Do you hold the dirt the entire time and then put it down on your knee? Or
no. It's like so.
Earth. This is getting really good.
And then it hits up to the chorus, and he goes, "And can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt." That was literally the fucking line. And when he first said it, he was like, "You can't buy happiness." I'm like, "Yeah." He's like, "But you could buy dirt," and I was like,
yeah, I'm.
What's it called?
I don't know.
You can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt.
You can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt.
Yeah. And so, like, as I'm driving, I'm like, I wrote my notes. I'm like, you can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt. So
I have no data connection.
Oh, I got it here. You can't buy happiness, but you can't. All right. And why did that irritate you?
It didn't irritate me. I just thought it was hilarious. But then, like, as I was listening to the song, it was basically a propaganda song. It was like a propaganda America song. It may, if you had a Bud Light, you know, that it was like America right there. NASCAR, okay. This song, buy some dirt, God.
Build a family.
Country, build a family.
Yeah, I saw that too. Yeah, you can't buy happiness.
You can buy dirt.
And he said dirt, and like, it, dirt. And I was kind of like, wait, what? And then I waited for the second time around, and I'm like, did he say dirt? And then as he's talking about.
2 days before he turned 80. He was sitting out back in a rock.
Yeah, you know, this is cool moonshine on a hot summer night.
And in between sips of coffee,
now the name of the band is it's a dude, and his name is Jordan Davis.
Five dirt.
What do you look? It first name doesn't relate.
Typical Jordans.
Yeah.
Listen to this emotional.
Here, hold on.
Bullshit.
Listen.
Played it church, send your prayers up and your roots down deep. Add a few limbs to your family tree. And watch
you can follow him on Instagram at Jordan More Chairs.
Yeah. Jordan wrote this.
Yeah, this
is the kind of content you get on his OnlyFans. Him doing his country songs.
I like dirt, okay? Stop it.
Let the man enjoy his dirt.
Buy dirt.
That is a cheap song.
It's dirt cheap.
Yeah. It's dirt cheap. Very nice.
Damn.
Like it. That's not really a rant, though, dog.
No, but I was just... it's also like...
it's a good rant.
It's propaganda coming through the radio, basically saying, like, go out there, buy some land. Buy some land, because that's the American thing to do. Yeah. And get married, make some children for the American dream.
Yeah.
Fight the Iraqis.
Yeah.
And praise Allah.
So you're sad that that's going to happen to your child?
No, I just thought it was just
and it'll be
kinda
that
hilarious
fault.
Well, it's just
an Asian baby is gonna be a country star.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
That'd be so tight.
That would be so cool.
I don't
so
even tight. Like country music, and that would be cool.
I would pay to see that. I would pay to see that for sure.
Yeah.
No, but also that people eat this up.
Dirt?
Yeah. Dirt. They eat dirt.
They eat
a lot of dirt. But no, like they just go like, yeah, yeah. And then they watch their games, and then they watch their fucking things, and they love the same commercials. And I don't know. It's just like, do people not see through all of this? Is it like, it's
no, that's what the Matrix is for.
Brought to you by the Matrix.
Resurrection. In theaters now.
Resurrected.
Well, you know.
Rebooted.
I don't know. Can't get on with that rant. But you know who can get on with that rant?
What is this, Beetlejuice?
Fucking Nick Bradfield. Nick Bradfield on the door!
Hello! Oh, spooky music for Nick.
Nick Bradfield, what do you got on some rants, motherfucker? Man.
I don't know how much of a rant this is coming off of that bad rant, but this is more just like the story of my Christmas, what I did. If you guys wanted to hear that.
Yeah, absolutely want to hear that.
Oh,
tell
okay.
me more.
Hopefully this is interesting. Oh,
yeah, I hope so, especially since you said that.
I know, yeah. It was like, it's kind of just what I got, what's been going on with me.
Rad.
But so I was supposed to come here for Christmas Day. End of the story, I didn't. Because
I didn't.
Yeah, I was supposed to be here, but a friend of mine from high school was like, dude, come on, we always used to hang out Christmas Eve, like, I'm in town, let's do it one more time. And I meet him at this place in Redondo, on the Redondo Pier, called Old Tony's, which is a swanky-ass place. This music is making the story.
It's so intense.
I know, but no.
Keep it going.
Sorry, I'm laughing because Brian just burned himself in the joint. I wish the camera was turned around for that. But anyway, no, it was like he was there and like two other guys who I didn't know.
Sad
and he was buying Long Island iced teas for all of us, and we were just having a lot of those. And the bill was on him, so it was cool. And then it was like, we're going back to his place. And as soon as we get there, he pulls out a bottle of vodka and like, let's do shots! And it was like, God damn, you guys slow down. Like, apparently these friends he was hanging out with, like, they're heavy fucking drinkers. And yeah, and then we were trying to play cards. And I didn't want to tell him that I forgot how to, like, what hands beat what in poker, so I was trying my best.
You didn't want to feel...
Like, I know, I wanted to feel cool.
You
and, like,
just got your phone out. Looked up
I know, I did that eventually. Yeah, then I remember... Then he brought out, like, a jug, and he said it was corn moonshine.
Oh no.
After that, the night kind of goes black, and then it was 3 a.m., and I woke up, and... one of them was puking in the bathroom, like, I'll just full-on hurling.
Typical.
He's like, where's my pants?
Yeah. And he was in there for a half hour, and then the other two were still fucking...
Have you seen my pants?
You want to say something, Jeff?
That's moonshine that was made by the band Korn, right?
Yeah.
You on that one.
Dirt moonshine, because it tasted like shit. But goddamn.
The master distiller was
Brian. And, like, at 3 a.m., like, I'm still drunk. I'm just a little, like, I'd slept a little, and they're still fucking drinking. And so we're just drinking more until, like, 7 a.m., and then they drive me back home.
They drove you home?
Because they were on coke, dude. That's how they could drink so much. They weren't drunk.
Yeah.
They were just coked out.
There was another friend that, like, drove me home, or, like, a neighbor or something.
I gotta get you out of here.
You don't know who picked you up.
These guys are gonna kill you.
You don't know who picked you up.
What?
You don't know who picked you up.
Who brought me home? No, not really.
Jesus Christ.
If you were a girl,
you'd be dead.
Well, yeah, but thankfully I'm not sexy.
If you were a girl,
no one's raping me.
You'd
be dead as fuck.
I know. Bradfield, I would have given anything for that.
Bradfield,
that would have been a Merry Christmas.
It's not true. They'd love you in prison.
True. All
right.
Yeah, you got a good face for prison.
Yeah, very kind eyes.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
But you got tits for
God. A lot of cushion for the pushing, as they would say.
Nice. But you get ripped in prison is the thing. Like, Brad,
I would love to see that. I would love to see Josh Bradfield.
He would have no option other than to get ripped because he's not going to get bottomed out. You know what I mean? Like,
well, for the first couple of months.
This is what happens. Yeah. He goes crazy in prison. Split personality, creates a musical where he gets ripped.
Oh, my God.
Then gets ripped within his own musical.
I tried to, like, think about what Nick would look like after prison, and the first thing that came to mind was Michael Scott going, I'm Prison Mike! I'm Prison Nick!
True.
That's just a bandana.
I'm completely
the
same.
Only difference.
I went and got ripped in prison. I'm still fat. I just got a bandana.
I got ripped in prison. Yeah. That would be, that'd be very bad.
My stomach didn't get ripped, but my asshole did.
Oh, my God. Jesus.
Ripped in half by a big black dick.
Well,
anyway.
I'm glad that you didn't get raped.
Yeah,
me
we're
too.
Happy
you know? Way back from Christmas.
Yeah, but then it was like, I arrived home. It was maybe like 7:30 in the morning, and I lie in my bed. And then, like, a few hours later, I see Zach's text or one of you texting me, like, get over here. I'm like, Yeah.
You were like, I can't move.
I know. And, like, Zach, it felt really bad because you, like, called me, like, right before I was heading out on Christmas Eve, and you're like, Nick, you want to come over? I'm lonely. Oh. And I'm like, oh, sorry, dude, I got plans. I'll see you tomorrow. And I didn't see you tomorrow.
Way to call me out, bitch.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm lonely.
You still have a good Christmas?
I'm always lonely.
Well, that's what happens when you're Jewish on Christmas. I'm sorry.
God damn. God,
sorry.
God damn.
Sorry. I'm a good Christian boy. Santa brought me presents.
He's not wrong.
Santa.
Well, good, man. I'm glad that you had a good time at Christmas.
I missed you guys, though. I will say that.
Yeah.
Were you guys all here on Christmas, or?
No.
Family, and Feldman decided not to come, so he missed out on the ham.
Oh,
well, let's hear from the man himself.
Yeah.
Jeffrey Feldman, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I'm upset that I missed the ham. I wanted to be here.
I love ham.
I was physically craving ham.
You wanted
and
that
I
ham,
wasn't
huh?
here, and it's you're just kicking yourself when you know that ham was available and you weren't there to get it. And I was at home napping. I could have been here 20 minutes away. And it just, it's really sad, it is.
Why didn't you come?
I didn't know you were having ham. I didn't know you were making it.
I love how that's the deal breaker. It's like no other reason.
Hold on.
No other reason but the ham.
He's positioned right now is so fucking.
And I'm upset that you didn't, like, you gotta tell us when you're cooking. You know?
Or what you're cooking.
Just or what you're cooking.
He looks like William Shatner doing Rocket Man right now.
I think it's gonna be a good ham.
I think he's doing a method acting piece like a Walking Phoenix.
This is kind of beautiful, bro. Yeah.
I'm a rocket ham.
It's almost like me and Sam are watching
Rocket
him
ham.
Himself right here, and we're like, okay, so can you do it again this time? But just remember the ham.
Just remember how the ham left you.
Yeah, yeah.
Remember all the ham you didn't eat.
Remember when the ham went out for cigarettes and never came back.
Yeah, remember the sugar. All
right, and if we could take it from, I wanted ham.
Yes. I wanted ham. I wanted it more than I wanted a warm hug from my father on a cold Chicago night. I wanted ham in my life, you know, like I was a starving child and I hadn't had eaten since last Christmas. I wanted ham in my life, like a Jew that feels left out of civilization. I wanted ham in my life, and what was I doing? I was at home.
Dig deep.
I was eating a salad.
Jesus.
I was. I really was. I was eating a salad and.
That was incredible.
Bring it home.
That was.
And can I tell you what I'm really upset about, though?
Yeah, yeah, go.
That, but, okay, so you're seeing, on CNN, I saw this video. People are now posting videos of people freaking out that are traveling during the holidays. And it's like, can we just fucking cut it out? I mean, yeah, it is entertaining to watch somebody lose their fucking mind because of all the stress that is on everybody's shoulders, you know, with the, you know, uncertainty of how are we going to make a living and when is this shit going to be over? And, you know, I just want to travel home to see my family who I fucking hate anyway. You know?
Then they take your fucking suitcase.
So do you want a hug?
It is entertaining to watch these videos, but it's like, can we just fucking put away the cameras? Can we? I feel like people are too comfortable flying.
He says on camera.
You know, like
Tobey
like,
Maguire
like,
vibes. Yeah. Tobey Maguire.
This
vibes.
Is a show. We need cameras. This is we need cameras here. I'm talking about when people
are cameras out of the airport.
I want
more
people,
security.
I want
He's tired of paparazzi following him around.
No, I want, I think that when you're flying, it's been too comfortable. The flying experience is too comfortable. Really like we're too comfortable in it.
I'm gonna cry.
Like it's like the only public transportation where people feel like they can make themselves. They're at home there. It's like
Greyhound.
When you're on a bus, when you're on a train, everyone just you know we want to get where we're trying to go. Let's just fucking keep that in mind. When we're flying, it's the same deal. You sit down, you find your fucking seat, you sit down, keep your mouth shut.
Get molested by a homeless man.
And let's fucking make our, you know, three or four ridiculous, you know, let's, what's it called when you switch planes?
Layover?
Let's layover.
Layover. Let's make our layovers. and let's get where we have to go. Let's cut it out with the fucking viral videos. With I saw this woman that was watching documentary of that chef that killed himself, Anthony Bourdain, which I think is great. I love Anthony Bourdain. I'm sorry that he killed himself. I mean, he probably had a good reason for doing it, because he did it. But let's just like keep all the documentaries about death and anything under the umbrella of death, like suicide, you know, killing other people, mass killing. Let's take that off the airplanes. All right, let's get where we have to go. Let's all keep our mouths shut. Let's not fucking get into it with each other, and let's enjoy our holidays. That's all I got.
Hey,
dude, what happened to you on an airplane?
You need a hug.
Yeah.
Immediately.
We should record that, give it to Delta. They should play that before every flight.
Right. Dude, you're stuttering like you're Jeff Goldblum.
That was probably one of the first times someone had a legitimate rant here.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I was like, actually,
dude, you
like,
got
hey.
Some stuff yeah. off your chest. Like the you look, came you look thinner. Like,
I'm pretty upset about the IRS.
True, you were mad when the IRS came after you.
The IRS. Fuck you.
Hey, all right, let's get it over to Jordan, bro.
Yeah,
Jordan.
Jordan,
the Messiah. I don't have much. I guess
you
I would
tell us exactly.
I
what
think
you have.
I think that bad parents are fucking pieces of shit, but I also think that sometimes good parents are also pieces of shit. I'm struggling. Like, I got my haircut, and I hate haircuts to this day because I think 3 days into high school, I got suspended. And my dad didn't say anything to me when he picked me up from school. And then the next morning he just said, get in the car. So I was like, all right, I'm fucked. So I get in the car and he's like, so what do you think I should do with you? And I was like,
beat my ass, dad.
You should ground me really like for a long time. That's a great
me,
idea.
Daddy.
You should for sure ground me. And he's like, but the thing is, whenever you're grounded, you just go up to your room and you read books and you're totally fine doing that. So that's not going to do anything. And he's like, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take something from you. I'm going to take something that you love and that you hold close to you as if it was your own identity in order for you to understand.
Did he shoot your dog?
How much? No, he pulled into the barber shop.
He made him shoot
because I had
dog.
Long. I had this long, beautiful hair. And it was like I was like a Matthew McConaughey wannabe, man. I loved it. And he's like, we're getting a haircut. And he went to the barber, paid him, shaved my head and was like, okay, go. Do whatever you want to now. So now every time I go to the barber shop, they're like, hi. I'm like, fuck you, dude. I did.
Get you away from my
me,
dad,
sir.
Don't you?
Get away from me.
What is he paying you? Like, what is he paying
never
you?
Never got caught doing bad shit at school again, but also like am really bad at getting haircuts now.
Fuck.
Yeah. You. So that's my rant. Like be a good, don't be a great parent. Be a good parent.
That's good advice.
Yeah.
But dude, I can relate to that because I remember like, I was around like 13 or 14 because my parents would always send me to my room and they realized like, oh shit, he just goes up there and like reads or goes on a, I think I had a computer back then. But yeah, it was like, oh, he goes up to his room and has fun.
My mom had the same problem.
Yeah.
I know. So it was like, shit, we can't do that anymore.
Yeah, my
parents had that moment.
Yeah, I would draw, write,
draw,
do whatever.
Play with whatever.
Yeah,
like,
your
it
dick,
didn't
whatever.
Yeah,
learn how to jack off.
Exactly. There's like plenty
of directions. I'm
So yeah, he was like, yeah, I'm just going to take something away from you because you have way too much fun in your room. And I was like, I was too scared to know what was going on at the time. And as soon as we pulled up the barbershop, I was like, damn, smart. Smart move.
That was smart.
Yeah,
though.
Smart move.
No, that's actually a good parent. You should hate him because that sounds shitty, but that is good parenting.
Yeah, no, that's solid.
Oh,
hate him. I couldn't do anything. I was like, this is just a good move. Like, I can't be mad.
Yeah,
I
mean.
Because as a teenager, you can be pissed off about whatever the fuck you want.
How old were you again?
I was 14.
Okay.
Yeah. Totally deserved all of it.
Can we get a close up of Brad Field's haircut right now? Where do you get your haircut at?
I will say it's a new place that's like right down the street from my house. I forget what it's called. It's like Anaheim Barbers or something.
I like how
like
it's
that.
Like it's like a low-key mullet.
Really?
And like, what do you
tell
mullet?
I really
it has
wish
the
I'd
elements of a mullet, but it is not yet a mullet.
What do you ask for?
Yeah.
I just say, can I just get a trim? I don't say much. I don't know much about hair. But no, I will say I wish I'd let them get cut a little shorter in the back. Just because, it is kind of low-key mullet. I was noticing that whenever I got
home. But I like
home.
It. It's mullets are fucking in right now.
You go to the same guy?
It's like it's screaming Pokemon cards.
The 90s mullet.
I own the entire
Do you go to the same guy?
OG Japanese set of Pokemon.
Oh, sorry. You can finish. No, that was my first time going to this guy. Actually, you know who I was getting my haircuts from before him?
Who?
My ex's mom, who's a hairstylist.
Oh.
So, like, even after we broke up, I was still, like, calling her mom, hey, can I get a haircut? She's like, yeah. How are you getting home? I know, yeah.
And you're like, fucking, how's your daughter?
What?
You're like, how's your daughter doing?
Dude, she would fucking shit talk her daughter to me all day long in there.
Nice.
And she's like, yeah, you're right to break up with her. What if, I was like, oh, my God.
So you're like, you're getting a haircut from her, and you're like, so what's going on with Jennifer? Is she still available?
Y'all got to keep the mic.
Boys, scoot in, really, scoot in nice
but she
and
would
cozy.
Tell me,
get all nice.
Because I picture. Give me a kiss.
Get Nick, scoot Nick.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Ooh. No, no, no. Oh, that's beautiful. Nick, picture of that. Get a fucking picture of that.
We need to commit.
Scoot your fucking chair.
This is Omicron. This is how you get transformed.
You got it.
Omicron.
Get in there.
I think we need to commit to the bit. And like,
get in there. No. Get in there.
Nose to nose. Yeah. The only your nose.
Separate. There you go. There you go.
Oh, the hat's going backwards.
The hat's off.
He's gonna catch himself a Nick Bradfield.
Hats off, man.
No, because I was just wondering.
Oh,
why.
Yeah.
Oh my
when,
God.
Oh,
yeah. Beautiful.
When your ex-girlfriend's mother would cut your hair,
she would.
Would you kind of like tell? Would you talk about your problems
with a little bit, yeah.
The ex?
I never really shared my problems with my ex to her, but she would share the problem with her daughter to me all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was totally on my side in breaking up. Yeah.
You guys make a really cute couple.
Oh, well, you know what?
You guys make a really cute couple.
I got a new girlfriend, looks like. Does your mom do haircuts?
Yeah.
Hey.
Hey.
Cool. Yeah, you're looking a little scraggly. You could use a haircut.
Oh, you messed up his hair.
Oh, yeah.
This episode is brought to you by Sport Clips. use the promo code Bradfield or Wacky Shack for an extra 15% off on all your
Everyone's on their phone.
Oh, no. This episode.
Oh, no.
This episode is brought to you by Male Kissing.
Get a zoom in.
By Male Kissing.
Get a free kiss in the mail with any order.
Sign up on our website.
All right, let's. You got it, Vetterman?
All right.
Technical difficulties.
You got it, Vetterman?
The studio can't handle
it.
All right,
Brian, let's wheel us back in to something.
Zach, it's your turn.
Is next
what's
up.
Your, what's in- your. What's your rant, amigo? I know we got some.
Hey, let me double fist these. All right, my rants of the week. Death is whack, and I hate that motherfucker. And I want him to know that I'm coming for him. All right?
Eventually, yeah.
You assume it's a guy?
He listens to the podcast.
We all are.
Hey, if it's a woman, I will hit a woman. But it's easier to say in public that you'll hit a man.
Don't know where that came from. Not sure what's going on.
Did someone die?
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Zach,
Zach, so casual about
way.
It, Brian. Yeah, of course.
Think of it this way. God. Death is just a bunch of bones, and the bones don't have gender. So you can hit death, even if it's a man or a woman.
Except for the fact that they can figure out what gender someone was by their bones.
All right, fuck it then, Zach. Sorry for trying to help you.
Yeah, bro. He's trying to just help you.
But if not, if it's like some demigod, like, death, there's no gender. It's just a skeleton. So there's a genderless skeleton demon.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're on my wavelength.
Yeah.
We're on wavelengths.
Uh-huh.
So who passed away, dog?
Yeah, my grandma died.
That's not surprising. How old?
She is 98 years old.
Oh,
98. That's, is?
Yeah. That's, she was.
It's a good long life.
98 degrees.
98 degrees.
That's sorry to hear about that, Zach.
That's a good life, though.
Yeah.
Was she cool, grandma? The fact that you had to think about
what
it.
What did she do back in the day? What was she like when she was younger? Do you know anything about her?
She was a wild lady, man. She
She met my grandfather when she was 17. He was about to go off to a war to fight the fucking Japs in World War II.
Nice.
You know, at his words, apparently.
Apparently.
Apparently. Yeah, I'm
sure they call them worse things.
The word you just said, of course.
I never met the man. Apparently, that's what he said back in the day. She met him when she was 17, and she told her parents, she was like, I love him. And they were like, no, we don't want you to see this man. He's going to go to war, and he's going to die, and it's going to break your heart. No.
I just wanted to bring up the sponsor one more time. This episode is brought to you by Sport Clips. Use the promo code. Use the promo code JAPS. JAPS for an extra 15% off your haircut. Back to you.
Back in the studio, Zach.
Promo code Gooks. Oh man, I could get canceled for this.
This is gonna be a heller of an episode.
So your grandma was sluting around trying to get a flyboy on her.
Yeah, basically.
Nice.
Was she on the side of an airplane?
No. He was anti-tank. So they were fighting Japanese tanks. In the Pacific Theater.
Where's the Japanese
call them? In the
Pacific Theater? Harusu Tokudanas.
Yeah, exactly.
Iron Turtles.
Oh my god.
The famous Iron Turtle. Yeah,
I'd come over to Japan and be like, yeah, y'all got any of them Iron Turtles?
What's that thing that ran over that motherfucking Tiananmen? You know about that shit?
Hey, the tank never ran over him.
No.
No, because he's Mario.
Yeah.
Turtle.
That shit was happening while
I was
being born.
He was a turtle.
The guy at Tiananmen Square, June 5th, 1989.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was the only thing good that happened that day. Yeah.
I died on the day Kurt Cobain killed himself.
You died on the day Kurt Cobain killed himself?
I was born on the fucking shit.
Crazy.
Wait a minute.
I was born on the day Kurt Cobain killed himself.
I popped out of the womb dead.
No, I mean, like, it was a rebirth.
Doctor
you died.
Slapped me out of
it. Sure. God damn it.
Your doctor slapped me on the ass and said, there's no point to living. Kurt Cobain is dead.
For extra 15% off.
You're like, stop.
This is the podcast where I openly said slurs, and that's the dumbest thing I fucking said. The thing I am most upset with myself with today.
Yeah, you said gooks today, and that's not still not
I know,
as
that's
bad.
Not even the worst thing I said.
He's in this, like, high N-words chair, coming like, up eating next. Mashed potatoes and pureed carrots, and he's like, Kurt Cobain is dead. Rape me. His mom's chain smoking, like, what the fuck is wrong with this baby? Like,
I gave up drugs for this.
Yeah, I gave up drugs for this.
That was actually a pretty good accurate impression of my mom. I gave up drugs for this.
I know, she's a lovely lady.
So
we have brunch every Sunday.
Yeah. So your grandma was a nice lady and
she kicked the bucket.
She kicked the old, it just feels weird because I'm so used to my, like, that side of my family, they're always like, they live forever. They never die. Motherfuckers just never die. And so I was like, all right, I got years. This bitch is going to clear 100 at least. Damn. Nope. Yeah.
Was she a Nirvana fan, though?
Oh, hell yeah. She was in the mosh pits going ham in Florida.
Was she like, you know, like with it, knew who everyone was?
By the end, no. Not at the end.
So
the
it was
end,
for the best is what you're saying.
Yeah. And my dad said that she was about to start... She oh God, what the fuck did she have? She was always sick with this one thing. So she was about to start going on another round of pills and
so she was a dog you would put her down.
A ventilator and shit. Like it was bro, before she lost her mind, she was like, will someone kill me, please? Like the doctors won't kill
my grandmother,
me. Will you guys just kill me?
No, my grandmother was saying the same shit. She was like, everyone's dead. Everyone I know is dead. I don't want to be alive.
Like that's the thing, I just living till that long just sounds like not no fun. It just sounds like
that's why Sweden's got that suicide machine.
Yep,
yes.
Suicide machine.
Back to throwback to last week's episode, you guys. if you've been binging on this like you should, Jesus
great
Christ.
Ska band.
Yeah, but I don't know. She before like she lost her mind. She'd like to tell us about how she used to work for Jewish mobsters. She was a secretary for Cleveland Jewish mobsters back in like the 40s and the 50s. for a long
Jewish
time.
Jewish mobsters sound adorable.
I know, I you know, we're say. So cute. We're not like Italians
or the
Irish.
You come to
Irish.
Me on the day of my daughter's bar mitzvah. You ask a favor from me.
I ask a favor.
Oh, guys, fucking Bradfield.
I'm going to make him an offer he can't refuse. It's money.
Yes.
First, I want to apologize to all Japanese listeners, and now I want to apologize to all Hebrew listeners. Thank you.
Do you call them Hebrew listeners?
Yiddish.
Hebrews! Oh, I'm sorry. Kikes! Okay, we can't do this episode.
After Gooks, I figured. Yeah.
This is the band episode.
This is not good.
We've said worse, bro. Like,
are you sure? Well, you're also brown, too. I'm very white.
We said all types of stuff. Yeah. Just not the one word that nobody can say.
Yeah. Hunt?
Spick?
Jesus
Christ. Hey, you know what?
Whoa. He's like, what did I sign up for? What is happening? We get real racy in this room.
This is pirate
radio.
We said
cutting spit, and he acted like it's the first time he saw a fucking pirate.
We want. They can't stop us. Come after us. This is the pirate ship, bitch. Comedians in California. If there's one,
that was like a little kid listening, watching his first firework. Whoa.
He said it, spit.
All jokes aside, this episode is sponsored by Sports Books. Use the promo code SPIX, SPICS, for an extra 15% off.
Spit on
SPIX.
Bro, I hope you're having fun in Jew heaven, whatever that looks
the
like.
The best heaven.
Right?
That's Fort Lauderdale.
No, she moved away. You know, she used to live in Florida, and then she moved back to Cleveland. It was like, why? And she's like, I don't know. It was warmer there. I liked it a lot better. It was like, all right, well.
Cleveland's warm?
No, she said it was, warmer in Florida.
Oh.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
It was nicer in Florida.
She was losing her mind.
Yeah, you know, she was.
That's called dementia.
Yo, if she was in Cleveland, you could have just told her it was Miami.
You know what a goiter is?
A fish?
It's a non-Jew, right?
I thought that was a fish.
No, that's a goyam.
No, that's the thing you like wrap around your body to make your make yourself seem thinner,
yeah,
right?
That's what
I thought that was a corset.
No, that's a girdle. That's the joke.
Goital.
The enlighten us, veteran.
Are you saying goital or goiter?
The grandma used to wear.
A goiter. It's like
a goiter.
I don't know. It's like a growth. She had this. She was fucking.
Yeah. It's that character from Lord of the Rings
she probably
who wants
was less
the ring
than
and, like,
80 pounds by the end.
Yeah.
And she just had this huge fucking. It looked like she had a fucking. It looked like she had swallowed a tangerine or something.
It was.
Why can't you take a goiter off?
It was so huge.
Because they have roots,
you know?
Probably. So if it's wrapped around anything
like
that,
some,
they can.
Yeah, nerves
like
some like nerves.
There was just they were like, you just gotta live with this thing now.
You ever see those dogs that have those things like?
Yeah.
Same thing.
Would she wear like a turtleneck or something?
The holidays are the most.
Yeah.
Powerful.
Yeah. If she were a dog, you'd put her down. So yeah, I got the goiter, got the fucking, you know, problems.
Well, Betterman, I'm glad that you got an opportunity to fucking see her before you came back. You know what I'm saying?
It's a real thing, you know. Like, it was kind of nice because when I saw her, I mean, to me, she seemed normal. Normal is the wrong word. Lucid, and it blew my dad away. He was like, "This is the most she's like been here in like months." And
nice.
I was like, "You're welcome. You're welcome for that." I'm just magical like that, you know. Because apparently,
you just blew weed smoke in her face.
I just radiated it. You know what? I dosed her before we left.
A little more energy.
I see.
Like in Braveheart, the king that's like just trying
to
muster
the
energy. The
nurses
like,
were already doing it. Yeah.
Right on her eyeball.
Yeah, exactly. I'm trying to get it. Trying to get her to see Jesus before she dies.
She's on ecstasy.
Yeah, but she's standing the fuck out in the corner like the demons.
The demons.
She hasn't like, moved this much since forever.
Just blow coke all over her face.
Right? Yeah. I wonder why Zach has been able to make grandma move so much.
Yeah.
Take another one, bro. He's got balloons full of nos with his grandma, and he's like,
big whiff.
Well, good dog.
Grandma, start huffing this bag.
But that kind of brings me back to when I'm around that age, man. I'm doing heroin.
But you used
heroin.
To do drugs with your grandma?
That's what I say. Yeah. If I make it that long, heroin. Bro, I'm going to do heroin gonna be
like,
for sure.
That's like, how
if
you
I'm
want gonna... your kid to find you, dog. Like,
yeah, I want them to find me ODing
now.
On the no, fucking... No, no.
Flipping the fuck
I'm not
out.
I'm not just going to, like, start. Yeah, I'm just going to, you know, like...
He'll ease into it.
Yeah, ease...
No, he's no. He said when
yeah,
he's
yeah,
when he's
heroin.
Older, he's
might
gonna,
as well, yeah,
he's
just
gonna
opium.
Start doing his heroin again.
Yeah, or I just have poppy my own poppy field, like in my backyard, and then I do poppy. I do tea, opium tea.
Can I say that's like actually a fear of mine that I'll be at a party and somebody's like, "Hey man, try this heroin. It's really good." And I have like a problem with saying no to people.
You're
and like,
okay.
Like, I don't know. I shouldn't. No
you're
man,
too
it's
polite.
Really good. I already paid for it and everything. It's like, goddamn. Yeah. All right,
like,
we're breaking
even,
stuff. We're breaking stuff.
It's because you're too polite. You're going to try heroin for the first time. Not because you're trying
you
to
gotta,
be peer pressure.
I'm the guy. Yeah. Dude, you got to try this heroin. It's fucking rad, bro. Come on. It's free.
I don't know, dude. I'm already kind of high.
Dude, I got the needle here. It's fucking righteous, bro. All right,
pause. Pause. Now, Bradfield, you're an Italian chicken salesman. And Feldman, you are now Bradfield.
I don't know, man.
Hey, come on! I got this.
Is this what casting directors do?
I don't know, bro.
Wait, you tried this.
I don't know if I can eat the whole chicken. It's a big.
It's like looking in a mirror.
Good job,
oh
boys.
My God.
That was a good improv.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Solid. You guys did a good
sucked.
Job.
You guys did a good job.
He said, hey.
By good, I mean it fucking sucked, man. I'm going to yell right into the microphone, hopefully.
That accent was just as good as the House of Gucci.
Yep.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Or Chris Pratt in the upcoming Mario movie.
Yeah.
Here, let's do another one. Okay, so Feldman.
What is this? Whose line is it?
You're an
anyway?
African, yeah, you're an African pizza oven salesman. And what's Bradfield?
Bradfield
is a transgender.
Is actually someone who is in the bathtub, and the guy just like went into his house to try to sell him the shit.
Okay.
Yeah, and he's actually been thinking a lot about his ex-girlfriend Julia, and he put on one of her vinyls that she used to listen to. That album was The Smiths, and he doesn't agree with it, but he likes to think about her and be close to her. And he also has a perfume that's lavender that he put in the bathtub.
Okay, all right, okay.
We have set up this scene.
Okay, hold on. That's all very well and good. That's perfect. All right. Okay, go ahead.
Hold on, I'm in the bathtub.
Okay, sir. I'm just here to sell a microwave oven pizza to you, sir.
I'm in the bathtub. I can't really... I can't answer the door right now. My hands are all wet.
But these aren't just any pizza, sir. I wouldn't bother you with crap. These are high-quality, gluten-free, kosher, freshly made microwave oven pizzas, sir.
My girlfriend left me, and I'm having a lot of withdrawals from Julia.
I'm very alone.
That's why I'm taking a bath.
Well, you know, speaking as an African man that just recently lost his wife, I can tell you that nothing relieves the stress like one of my own pizzas that I have for you, and I can cut you a good deal.
What's curing my stress right now is listening to the vinyl record of the Smiths. Because she owned it and I didn't
great
give
band.
It back. Yeah.
Fabulous.
I don't really agree with them, but it reminds me of her.
Listen. Why don't you let me let me in?
But I'm still in the bathtub, sir.
Well,
just Bradfield in the bathtub, but I'm still in the bathtub, sir. I don't know how to help you.
Why don't you get up?
Okay.
Dry yourself off.
All right, I got a towel right here.
Come, let me in.
Okay.
I'll let you try one of these pizzas, and then you decide for yourself whether you like the pizza. I might even get, you know, at this point, I'm more your friend. I'm not trying to push it on you. I just want you to try it and see how good it is, and if you don't like it, then I'll leave you alone.
All right, that sounds good, sir, but I just want to warn you, when you walk in, you're going to smell lavender.
Love lavender.
Okay, good. I just want to make sure you're okay with it, Julia.
They're like bringing it all around.
Yeah.
It's really covering.
That's a professional. Oh, that is a professional right there.
That's what you do at an audition. They give you what you got to put in all of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You
gave me a real
like
one.
Lavender.
Yeah. Yeah. Good job, guys.
Jeffrey, you're a really good African dude.
Absolutely. Wow. Great. Right. Absolutely.
Awesome. Good job.
Damn, blew me away.
But,
yeah, that made me laugh.
That was awesome.
Woo. Yeah. All right. Awesome. So my rant, dog.
Yeah.
Sure.
Good luck.
Good luck following that, dude. Right.
Exactly.
All right.
Ooh. Fuck.
So my rant is I hate improv. I think it's silly, bro. No, the only rant that I have is I feel like, and this is gonna sound real fucked up, dog, and I know y'all aren't gonna.
Oh, we haven't said fucked up stuff this whole podcast.
Fuck Betterman's
so
grandma.
I know, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Another dead Jew, boo hoo! Like,
I'm glad I got to fuck Zach's grandma before she died.
You fucking owe me $50. Yeah. Hey, bro, I'm just really, really mad at myself for mismanaging money, dog.
You smoke too much weed.
No,
it's just, you know what it is, man. It's the Bitcoin remorse, dog. It's what I'm starting to call that feeling when you realize you should have jumped in on something or done something.
You're going to FOMO about something. You're going to FOMO right now.
I've been
telling you this shit for how
many years?
No.
It's the feeling, not necessarily about that. I'm just talking about anything in general, like whether it's like not just financial, but just like an opportunity to do something, like do. You know, I think that's called regret. Well, sure, rant or whatever, but I've just been mismanaging my money financially, and it's becoming a bit of a fucking bummer. And I'm like, man, like there's got to be a better way, dog. Like,
well, see, the thing that's
a bummer is that last rant, aren't you?
Yeah, so, I'd rather hear about Zach's dead grandma.
It's a rant. It's a real rant, bro. Yeah. I'm tired of that shit, bro. I'm tired of fucking just, you know what I mean? Like, it's like sometimes it's like, let a motherfucker just be like a stop, you know?
Those
like,
are emotions.
Just be like
that's raw emotion.
They be looking at me and shit and they be like,
do something.
Yeah, do something with their, you know?
Something with your life.
And it's like, damn,
so,
but like, you know.
What's one of the biggest things that you do that leads to you not having the money that you want?
I think one of the oh, what's up, Mikey?
Oh, get in here, dog.
Come on in.
Look who it is, everybody.
Hey, yo.
What's up, big guy?
I think we might need
hey, what's up?
What's up?
Hello.
What's up, man?
Yeah, we can. I'll just, I don't know.
Oh, you're good. I think it's a whole spang in here.
Open a window, he says.
I don't know, man. I guess like if I had to say.
No, but for real, so like, what do you spend money on?
Yeah, like what's your
besides weed?
Yeah, I mean weed's a lot of money. In a week, how much money do you spend? How much money do you spend in like a month on weed, just weed alone?
I don't know. I don't want to talk about it.
No. Oh wait.
Oh wait. No. Oh, fuck you.
You brought it up.
You're here, baby. No,
I'd probably say 60 bucks every
day.
No way, bro. 60 bucks every day? No. Yeah. I'd probably say about 25 bucks every 2 days. Like,
so in a month, how much is that?
Add that up.
So yeah. 4 days is $50.
Yeah. Oh, dude, I also felt the same way about like spending money. But as soon as I like kind of sobered up a little bit and stopped drinking, I had so much more money in my bank account. It was ridiculous.
The same thing happened too when I stopped drinking. Yeah. So I'm assuming.
So I'm sure that when you quit, you're going to quit smoking for the New Year's, right?
Smoking cigarettes.
Cigarettes. Okay. Even that.
That's something.
Yeah. Because I stopped smoking cigarettes too. Like there's plenty of things that you can stop doing just if you want to.
And then the other thing that you do that I've noticed is you'll do something like put some money in an investment to put away, and then as soon as things get a little hard, you pull it right back out.
Right.
First sign.
Yeah.
And like when you put that away, that's gone. You never get to touch.
I gotta remember that too. Like I gotta put that away because like there was so much of it during the quarantine because I had a big chunk of money, dude. Like before quarantine,
dude,
like,
I feel
quarantine
that
went through like probably the most I've ever had in my life. Like, and I was like super hyped about it. And like
that government checks
and like the, you know what I mean? Everything was going into, I had a thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was like, you know, the first time that I felt like I don't know, you know what I mean? And but then, like, everything started happening, and, like, bills started piling up, and then it was like, bruh, you know? And, like, you know, and then when the old lady started coming by, you kind of keep forgetting about that. And I used to tell Sam all the time, bro. Sam would be like, you're gay as fuck. I'd be like, I'm not gay, motherfucker. Like, I just don't want to fucking, like, you know what I'm saying, get into anything, because I'm going to get into it, like, 100%. And, like, when I do that, I like to be, like, a nice dude, you know what I'm saying? Like, I like to do the right thing. Like, it's like another
person.
So when you, I
know what you're saying, because I notice when you're dating someone, or me, anybody, like, you're not eating for one now. Now you're paying for two most of the, like, every other time.
Yeah, everything mm-hmm. doubles. Even when you guys are trying to, like, be the most, like, chill and cool, and it's like, and no, 50-50. Don't worry about it. Like, it's cool. Like, yeah. Everything's cool. And it's like, at the end of the
you
day.
Want a, you want a Snickers bar, too?
It turns into, yeah. like, a whole thing and mm-hmm. a whole
Twix.
And sometimes there are times where it's like, you're just doing something because it's, like, kind of the thing to do. And that bill will pile up, too. And it's like, goddamn, like,
yeah. Yeah. Especially, you know, after the holidays. Yeah.
I don't know. It's very interesting because, like, and something that I personally don't necessarily have to factor in regularly. And so, like, that with the lack of the job and then everything, it just all kind of, like, turned into this one thing. And then it's just like, damn, bro. Like, if I had just bought some fucking Google shares when I was two, you know, like, yeah. I'd be the richest little baby in the world. Like, but it's also an example of, like, what to do from here on out. And really take the new year seriously, mm-hmm. And, like, take a big advantage of that. Because, like, a lot of people, when they come into the new years, they're kind of like, oh, well, you know, what's it going to change? And, I'm like that, too, to be honest. Like, I get to a point where it's like, what's it really matter? The day's the day. It's whatever. But, like, when you really think about it, it's like give ourselves an opportunity, you know, to, like, really, really do it. Like, Jordan's been doing magnificent, and, like, Bradfield stopped his cigarettes, bro. Like, he stopped his cigarettes, bro. Bradfield was smoking like a motherfucking chimney, dude, and he stopped his fucking cigarettes. Like, I don't know. It's just good that everybody's doing that, you know what I mean? And that it's not just, like, you know, not just Sam now, you know what I mean? Like, it's like, Feldman always goes to the gym, you know what I'm saying? He's hella yoked, you know what I mean? Like, everybody's doing something, and so it's kind of like, for me, this New Year's, I'm really going to be like, yo, all right, cool, like, mm-hmm. no cigarettes, like, I'm done with cigarettes.
But also, like, give it a shot, like, a couple weeks with no weed.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, I'm telling you.
The thing that you really want to focus reset. On, I understand might. That you're recessing a little bit just based on your body language, but you don't have to be perfect the first time you try that. Like,
of course not.
You could be like, I'm gonna give it a shot and see what happens,
and that's fine.
And yeah, just don't hold yourself like so accountable the first time you try to like cut yourself out from something.
I'm not too
should
worried.
You try that.
I think if anything, what I want to do is I want to do a more honest effort,
right?
Financially,
just in case, because I know that I would always be like super pissed off of myself whenever I tried, like when I would go back drinking, when I go back smoking, whatever, and I'd be really pissed. But that's not even the process. Even at rehab centers, they don't say like they say that what's it called? What does it mean when you stop being sober?
Relapse.
Relapse. They say relapse is the road to recovery.
Yeah, it's
because,
part of it.
Yeah, that's like so. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
That's
don't
an
beat
actual
up
thing.
Yeah. yeah don't ask a bunch of AA motherfuckers about that because they'll freak the fuck out. But
right.
no,
yeah.
I mean it is very much part of the process.
Yeah.
I never heard that before, but that's interesting.
Yeah. I'm 100% for it. I'm in it. I'm down to do it. You know. But the financial aspect really. Recently, especially after the holidays, after all the money spent for presents and everything, you still got to pay rent and everything, you pay all the bills and stuff, and like, it's kind of like, damn, bro, like, you know what I mean? Like, even before you found your golden egg, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what it's, everybody knows what it's like at that point. I have to just fucking start. Except maybe he'll twinkle toes over here, you know what I mean? Like, because he's still a young child.
Memory card.
Yeah, memory card. Just said it was full.
That's fine. That's all right.
Okay.
This is still recorded. I think maybe we got like 5 minutes of it. But that's my rant. So I guess, you know, at the end of the day.
So you just got to be real with yourself at the beginning of the year.
Sit down.
Yeah.
Take assessment of my financial position.
Don't lie to yourself.
Oh, I never do. You know?
Yes, you do.
I'm going to look right at that motherfucker.
Yes, you do.
And I'm going
to
be like.
That was a lie to him. Himself.
Here's my number. You know, call me.
I don't
me.
Have a weed problem.
Yeah.
I never said I never had
a
weed problem.
He doesn't have a weed problem. He gets weed just fine.
I never had a problem with money because even with my wife, who's like a fucking sick ass millionaire or whatever.
God.
Yeah, never. I I always live within my means. It's very, like, even though I don't have a lot of money, I have enough money to get by, to pay all my bills, and I know that. And that's, like, even though I don't have more money, like, that doesn't mean it's not coming.
Right.
But I don't have to sit there and be like, oh, man, I hope I do this. Like, sure, I got a golden egg, but I was living in a shared room, like,
no,
before
that's
what
that, I'm
and saying
I was before totally,
like,
then. Like, yeah, before
now
that.
I'm still kind of living in a shared room.
Like, but. I remember very fond. I never look back at those rooms that I had to share, like, apartments with them and was like, oh, man. But it was just like, this is the road. Like, this is the process. And, like, I'm not going to be here forever, and that's okay. But, like, to think about it as if I had missed an opportunity seems unfair to, like, tell that to myself because everyone's got their own road.
I missed an opportunity on what? Tell us more about, like, that shared room.
What you were saying? The shared room?
No, I'm with you. I'm just.
He just kept trailing off. I didn't know when to start talking.
I'm not worried about no shared rooms or nothing like that. It's all I'm just saying in general. It's just like, I guess everyone at one point or another reaches a certain maturity.
But hey, you got a resolution now, a New Year's resolution. Yeah, you got something to work on.
Exactly. Yeah. I got a little something to come home from.
Yeah, be realistic, though, about your, not like shitting on it. Yeah. But just do realistic, go, like, you know what I mean? Like, they cut down to like 3 days and then to 1 day a week.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I think that's better. And especially with cigarettes, definitely do like some kind of nicotine substitute because it doesn't work.
Even like the websites that tell you.
I don't even like cigarettes as they are. Like, I smoke like one.
Oh, then you don't really need to worry.
Yeah,
but
I know
in
about 2 weeks
but if
I'm
you
gonna
do,
literally just not want to
But
do
if
it
you
anymore,
do get a craving and you want to buy cigarettes, just buy that instead.
Yeah, yeah.
Even all the websites that like talk to you about like quitting smoking, they're always like, yeah, you should just get like a nicotine patch,
and, like,
the gum or whatever.
And now it's 10%. Of everything I get now goes into the savings now. Everything. Yeah. Bop. I've just been bopping things into the savings, dog. The other thing, too, never trusted the banks, dog. I used to get my bank account jacked by the government all the time because of rent.
Deposit.
Because of all types of other wild shit or things like that.
That
so I
overdraft
used to,
protection bullshit.
I used to keep all my money in fucking people's boxes and shoe boxes and shit like that. And I would have it in my house and all this type of wild shit.
I do the same thing. Bartender.
You know? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So
all my money was cash. All
right, so here we are near the end, guys.
Yeah, but then your money's just deflating there.
Well, that's I guess that's another part of it too. But you can have
no, it stays right
home.
There. It doesn't go anywhere.
I mean,
yeah, but he's saying it could go up. You
the
can,
money?
You can make your
in
money work
bank.
For you, so it's not just sitting there.
Sam's
like,
a 10% kind of guy.
That's the first step. The first step is having money. The second step is what you're talking about.
Yeah.
We'll get to that one
eventually.
In a later episode.
I mean, yeah, but you can still get 4% or up on $100 bill.
He's our resident 1%er.
Hey,
so you're saying just take some money and then put it where? To get 4%.
There's a few spots. You can either go into some stable coin and then put those out. What do you call? I can't even think of the word. But basically, I can't think of the word. But you can get up to 8%, 10% on those.
I can't think of what it is. It's a thing.
It's
but if you go there
thing.
And give them your money, you get 8%.
Well, I'll tell you what.
It came in hot.
It's stable coin.
Send me that information.
For sure.
Send me that information. Because
I
do, like, at this point, I have a little bit. And I'm like,
this was our first.
Send me some shit.
Okay.
Yeah. That 70s style show. So thank you.
Stake it. There we go. I can't think of the word. Stake it.
Thank you very much for staking your attention. On today's
Low
episode,
blackjack.
I'd like to go around the table and ask everybody where we can find them motherfuckers at. Let's go ahead and start over here with the Hawaiian Mafioso himself.
You can find me not at Hawaii, but at Wacky Shack 360 on Instagram.
You gotta keep going, though.
And Nick Flicks and Jill. Ooh, nice.
Hey, what's up, y'all? You can find me at The Real Crystalia on TikTok and YouTube. I upload a lot of fun cooking videos and wrestling videos. I'm going to be wrestling Zach's grandmother. I'm just kidding. shout out to all my peeps in Fort Lauderdale. Thank you, guys.
Oh, yeah. You can find me at Jordan Moore Chairs on Instagram. And that's it. Go away. I hate you.
You can find me, Zach Vetterman, on Instagram at Comedy Hazard, comedy_hazard.
Oh, is it Sam's turn? What's up? See you guys. You can find me at Sam_tattoo_13 or at Zozo_art studio. Thank you.
Is now a good time to tell Nick and Jeff that the camera's off?
Oh, yeah. Oh shit, we forgot.
You forgot. We got him, folks. We got him.
Yeah.
You guys can find me at @TheReal_BRYAN. TV, but you can also find the rest of our amazing shows anywhere you guys look for podcasts, such as Happy News with Perry Curtis, Roll 420, is this, that, and the other, MDK Squad Pod, baby. We got Nights on that motherfucker also. We got Eclectic Radio coming up. We got Netflix and Chill showing up too. We got Underground Sound on the way. We got all types of shit working in the corner. We got videos popping up on YouTube on this new year. You guys are going to be seeing all types of shit popping up right up in your face, bro. It's going to be like a bukkake of content, motherfuckers. It's going to be all up in your grills, man. Make sure you bring plenty of protection,
man.
But most importantly, make sure you check our website out, bingeonthischannel.com. You can check out the Gauntlet comedy page on there as well, guys. They got everybody's little links on there. You can click on the button, so you can check that shit out. If you want to find out where you want to see some of Sam's crazy 3D, 5D art, go check it out on the website. Go check it out on his link tree, guys. Go let them know that y'all love them. But most importantly, remember to love each other, stay safe, and to dream the dream of a thousand dreams.
And show some love to the sponsors. Today we've
and
got
to the sponsors. We've got
Bradfield's Goiter Removal.
Ooh.
Geronimo!
You use the promo code.
Cut him off, Adam. What's your sign off?
Don't forget to tickle the taint.
Jesus Christ.
Hell yeah.
That's how you're going to end it? Yeah.
No, you got something?
No, we stopped. Oh, yeah. What's your sign off, Bradfield?
You want to say gook one more time?
Sign off?
No, what's your Bradfield? I mean, what's your sign off?
What's my what? Wacky Shaq. Boom.
There. We're done.